Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. And seeing as you're already here, and if you're not subscribed, you might as well subscribe, so every single time I post my amazing content, you're the first one to view it and also like the video. And also remember to press the bell, so every single time I post, you are the first one to be alerted. Now, if you saw from my previous video, I've done a challenge called the ice challenge, and it actually really damaged my skin. It literally burnt through layers of my skin. And this is also called frostbite. It is a challenge where you put salt on your hands, like loads of salt, and then you put ice straight from the freezer onto your hands, and you hold it down onto your skin for as long as possible. But what people don't understand is the longer you hold the ice, the more damage it is doing to the under layers of your skin, and the more damage it is doing to your skin. Literally, if I was to leave that ice on for any longer, my arm would have got amputated. Like, this is what it done to my arm. And don't worry, if you can't see properly, I'm gonna attach some videos and pictures at the end of this video so you would get a clearer understanding of what actually happened. Now, when I wake up, I'm starting a new routine. I just don't do a face routine. I have to do a routine for this burn on my hand because I do not want it to scar. God, please don't let it scar. So what I do when I wake up, I put on my Solution Vibes cleansing pads, and this is from Avon. So if any of you have burns, it doesn't just have to be frostbite. It could be any sort of burn, burn from a chemical, burn from an iron, whatever sort of burn it is, just follow these steps and it will help you. I literally just run over it with this pad, right? That's what I do. I run over it with the pad. As you can see, there's nothing there. And if you haven't got pads, just use wipes to just really clean that surface area. And you can also use different soaps. So for example, you can wash it, you can wash around the affected area with a specific soap. It could actually be black soap, the black African soap, or it could be the Skin Success Complexion Bar to just lighten the area and bring it back to its color. If you do not have any of these soaps, use lemon and natural lightening. You could use natural lightening. And then what I do after is I'm going to try applying maybe a mask to that area, a peel mask. So when I peel it off, the more I peel off, the more scab it will remove. So I think this is something that I'm going to try today. And it's not going to damage that area because it's quite well now. It's not old. It's not an old wound. Sorry, guys. I mean, it's not a new wound. So it's not going to bleed. It's quite, yeah. It feels quite dry. I can touch it now. I can feel around that area more. So I'm going to apply the face mask to that area, the peel off charcoal mask, and then I'm going to leave it on for about what's going on here? This is new. Oh, it's new. I haven't used it before. Like, how much products do I actually have in my room? Like, honestly. And guys, the reason why I'm doing this to the affected area is because it does look badly damaged and I'm trying to fasten the process. Oh, so guys, as you can see, I've applied quite a lot. And I'm going to lather it in on that area. And then just let this do its work. Yep. I'm going to let it do its work. That's simply what I'm going to do. And I'm going to let it dry. So for this much to dry, it's going to take maybe about 30 to 40 minutes for it to really dry. And guys, this should actually make a difference, because what I'm doing is I'm getting rid of the dead skin cells. That is what I'm doing. I'm not peeling it with my hand physically, because that's something you cannot do. You're going to cause an infection. Okay, do not peel it physically with your nails. Do not do it. Do not add any harm chemicals to your hand. Do not do a chemical peel to it, because I'm seeing a lot of people doing extreme things, but I'm just taking it bit by bit. Now, some of you may be thinking, what's frostbite or any type of injury that causes a burn to the skin? And what this does, it affects the underlying tissues, and your skin becomes very red and numb and hard and pale. In my circumstances, it was hard and red. So I'm just going to go on to just reading a bit more, because I'm not just trying to focus it on frostbite, I'm trying to focus it on other types of burns. Okay. So what it's saying is that there's a lot of like complications that happen when you have burns on your hands and so forth. But I would just say to take care of it naturally, and especially that we're in lockdown, like the doctors, the nurses, they don't have time for us. So we've got to heal this ourselves. We've got to do this ourselves. And another important factor I would say to you is, once again, if you can't remember what I showed you, this is the Solutions Cleansing Pads from Avon. And when you go in the bath, you can wash the affected area with black soap. And also the Skin Success Complexion Bar. And then lastly, after you've already peeled off the affected area from the sheet mask, you can then use this as your last resort, the African Shea Butter. And don't worry guys, these little black spots is eyelash glue, it's just not coming off. Shea Butter, okay? Shea Butter. And Shea Butter has a lot of natural remedies and is really good for scars, stretch marks, blemishes, and so forth. So if it works on those type of skin conditions, it's going to work on the burn. So guys, keep all of these tips in mind, these DIY tips. Don't go over the top too much. Try and do what you can. Don't just leave it to heal on its own. Yes, leave it to heal on its own, but also add some natural remedies to the skin to help it recover quicker and better. If you have any questions, please comment down below, because I always reply to you guys, and I also have a lot of solutions, and I'll put the product descriptions down below. So guys, don't forget to like, comment and subscribe, and press the bell, because I have content coming out daily. Enjoy the rest of your day and stay safe. So the charcoal is starting to harden. I did add a lot of layers. I just really want to see dramatic change around the affected area. And I'm going to peel it right before your eyes. So make sure you stay tuned. And please subscribe to see how this burn actually recovers. Guys, it's actually taking this long. I've got my hand stuck at the window. My hand is stuck at the window. I'm trying to let this dry because it's literally taking so long. Hi guys, I'm back and I think the charcoal has now dried. It's not dried fully, but it's dried enough. I think this bit's still a bit wet, but you know, I'm just gonna do this every day until I see a change in the appearance. So guys, please don't forget to like, comment and subscribe. And just keep supporting me as I keep bringing out amazing content for you guys. And please press the bell.